still pretty much in control. Yeah, when the attention is not divided like this, Myanmar, they're focused at just trying to take out here for the side of Philippines.
Able to stun down Canon, he's actually low, and the Cult Altar will go down. But so far, it looks like it will be in vain. A good defense by the Philippines.
Wait,
and
what?
Whoa!
Ruby Deity overstepping the boundaries there, diving. Inside the base, I believe, of
LPH. I think he dove and Unigo was able to hook him back as well.
Massive overstep. And now, it's going to be a 4v5 for 19 seconds as the Lord spawns.
Saisonzo.
Bottom side of the map.
It is Illuminous Lord 2. Saison on the top end of the map. Is this something of a message coming from Philippines? Or are they actually going to give this away?
I don't think Myanmar is confident enough to just burst the Lord. Especially that they don't have the damage because they don't have the luxury of showing Zippy in front of the Lord here because he will just be caught off guard by Philippines. Saison can actually catch up with Arcangel if ever the Valentina just comes in.
Naomi's nowhere to be found here. He's actually pretty far away. He's near Arcangel. He's near Rekitiano. But where's the fight gonna happen? That's a big question so far for the Philippines. And so, and I think at this point, Myanmar has a better position.
And Myanmar will be able to pull it back to their end too. This is the power of the Barats, the sheer sustain that it has to tank a lot of shots from the Lord. And Canon, Unigo, Arcangel will be surrounding him for a while. They know for a fact that they cannot burst down this Barats, but you also have this sword already in half HP. You have to respect that.
Naomi is looking for a potential kill on the backline. He sees the Claude. Ruby Deity though, gets the kill on Arcangel.
The combo of Ruby Deity and Naomi demolished Arcangel right there. Rubidini's still alive, penalty zone is down. Justin again, very close by, but everyone just not seeing Zippy. Good positioning from the marksman of Myanmar.
3-for-none. Yeah, it's the Naomi factor, the vision that he saw. He saw the Claude and Valentina walk through mid, and Zippy was in prime position to help and try and help to get the kill. Rubidini as well came in to the Valentina, and Philippines, they were just not ready.
The biggest question there was, before that board fight started, where was Naomi?
And they got answered by a claws to the face and probably an execute too. Myanmar now leads by 3,000. Look at the items coming in from Naomi. Full damage, Natalia, of course, that's the only way to build it. Still hurts a lot. That's three items locked in already.
Yeah, Wind of Nature built up now on Rekishano. And Saison still has that Molten Essence, so especially with the hybrid build, War Axe and Endless Battle. But again, as you've mentioned, this carry is going to start first. He will build up for the Ooze Midir carry here, especially if it's a Valentina. It helps because it adds mobility to carry, and it provides a shield that blocks all sources of damage.
And a Rose Gold Meteor is also locked in here for Zippy, as you said. A lot of mitigation of damage here coming in from Myanmar. They could potentially get a lot of inhibitor turrets from here if Philippines can defend.
Let's see how they're going to pull up the defense with Lord on top side. They are able to clear on bot side.
Unigo
is starting the fight. That's another very, very long hook. But the Cult Altar comes out just in time, although it is now wearing off.
Ooh.
Fight being initiated on by Saison. Zippy goes down. That's a 4v5 for a long time there, but the ultimates are out already for the Philippines. Another good hook coming in to Ruby Deity. Forces the immortality out and makes him go down. Although there is a revenge play coming in from the Philippines by Naomi.
It's a 2-for-2. Saison and Arcangel goes down on the side of Philippines. Great play coming in from Naomi. Still has that execution.
Oh! Eagle was
four
good for three!
3-for-3.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. Philippines, after that kill, that was basically Unigo just using Conceal and getting the hook land. Like, I believe it was Zippy. And even though Justin was able to save that teamfight for Myanmar with the Cult Altar, they were met with the penalty zone coming out from Canon, and all of them focused on bringing down the carry. At some point, there were three frozen heroes on the side of Myanmar because after the Cult Altar, you stand there for 2 seconds and they took the full brunt of the damage from the Blazing Duet.
And Myanmar now will be leading this game still by 3,000, but as this game progresses longer, we're getting closer and closer to that point in time where everybody has items in. we're just waiting for the winner of the last team fight. Ruby DD has been very stellar in this game.
Yeah.
1-4-10 on this Joy. We asked during the draft if it could play this well, and looks like the answer is absolutely yes.
The spicy heroes are definitely perfect for Ruby DD right now.
Very
I'm seeing a pattern right now, though. Every time Myanmar gets a Lord, it's like they lose a little bit. I don't know why.
Run on.
So good right now, the Philippines playing with the Lord dances.
Well, Ruby DD, as much as he has been able to add much damage to Philippines, Arcangel is such a big problem. You know, whenever he gets a card altar, it feels like the Joy is sort of like forced into a position where he either needs to commit or needs to back off. So you're always under the threat of being bloody hunted by the
Mars. Look at really the damage! Rushing into it. Saison can't survive, and Naomi's certainly back. He's hunting down Saison. Lord's gonna go down, and Zippy will secure it. What's Philippines gonna do
right now?
It's gonna be the
Ruby
winner. First Rhythm of Nature, Ruby DD on the side as well. Saison takes him out.
And Naomi hunting for his next prey. Finds Rikishano. And looks like Cannon is next. But he finds the quad only. Kanon is still alive by an inch. The immortality wouldn't be really popped there.
What a call by Myanmar.
What a performance coming off from this Natalia. Naomi, again, you know, shredding the HP of Saison, and the Lancelot needed some space to recover. He did get some HP back, but when he returned, Myanmar was already finished with the Lord, with Zippy as well, helping helping Ken to take out the objective, and Ruby DD offering himself towards the Lancelot was also crucial to that teamfight for Myanmar.
Yes, beautiful decision-making overall for the Myanmar squad.
The world is watching a Lord in the mid lane. Philippines, can they defend this?
Big what if, but everyone is ready to go for the fight. It's gonna be Daytona's welcome going down, but it will be canceled. Ken is gonna be suffering. So far, so good for Myanmar. They are able to push back the Philippines, but
Saison
gonna go for it. Saison playing around in the middle of everything. Penalty zone goes down by Kanon. He's getting hit on by Zippy. Saison in the back. Beautiful by Mayunigo. Ruby DD will fall.
Arcangel, he's still going at it, but he's all alone.
Yes,
gets set up by his own call altar, but Unigo gets pulled in by Zippy here. Zippy trying to kite away with the immortality still
Naomi?
Up. Zippy, he's going in.
He is, he's not done. Naomi, who is going to be the target? Arcangel finds him, but he gets deleted. Oh man, that's 2-for-none in the span of 30 seconds.
Naomi showing himself up towards the Lancelot, stop Saison from participating on that fight. Would have been amazing for the Philippines, but Ken also standing his ground with the heals from the Tonus welcome. He was able to survive the initial damage burst coming out from Arcangel.
Saison though might be in trouble here. They still don't want to end this push. Myanmar might be overstaying their welcome. Valtar?
Zippy is just so powerful right now. It's gonna be hard for the Philippines to stand up to this guy.
Oh-ho!
But the hook goes down, and Justin is gonna be the victim. Saison trying to make his mark, trying to help out Rikishano as much as he can. Able to clear out the minions in time.
Oh my goodness, the Beast Hawks coming out from Onigo is what's stopping from Myanmar in taking this game. You know, this game feels like Myanmar's already, especially with Naomi's performance, but Onigo with the hooks, with the hunt on Ruby DD, stopping all possible aggression from Myanmar.
And you know, the thing about Unigo in this game is that he will land the most crucial hook to extend this game further for Philippines. And for Myanmar, Naomi feels like that homing missile where he just finds those people that actually needs to be eliminated and finds them alone, destroys them one by one. And Naomi is already known as a great Natalia player, but I do feel like he got even better.
Look at Saison, he's making sure that there's no Natalia around the vicinity, but still they're not showing themselves.
He knows. He's there. They can feel each other, I'm sure. High level MLEB so far.
They don't know. They don't know the Lancelot's here.
Okay. The Lancelot. Oh, there it is. Naomi will find him. There's a combo, and somehow Saison dodges it.
No puncture, I think, for the Lancelot.
Now, what's it gonna be? Half HP on the Lord. Unigo with a conceal. But apparently, Philippines thinks it's just not worth it to go in just yet.
Are they thinking that this is a faint? There's a big wave up top. Naomi could go for the end here.
Arcangel. Does feel like it. Naomi's in the back. Arcangel is a big problem. Saison Gonna be able to dodge on out of Daytona's welcome.
Oh, the reset,
and the reset is gonna happen. Naomi's got like Zippy gets a kill as well. It's a 3v5 defense.
Oh, what a macro call from Myanmar. The diversion in execution.
Yeah, and again, Naomi, he knew that somebody had to defend it. It was the Valentina, it was the Arcangel. Without the Valentina, without a copy of the call over, they cannot fight. And the reason the Lord Nigo. Figure out.
It's a 3v5. Don't forget, it's only 30 seconds before Canon and Arcangel makes their way back. So I think it's going to have to be the reset for the Philippines for now.
And we're already 22 minutes in. When we think about the Natalia, we always think about how it's a big early game threat. But this is definitely, most definitely in the late game already.
He's like a nuke.
And he's like a nuke. He 100-0 a lot of people.
Okay, so it's going to be a big question. Can the Philippines hold, though?
Our base lock!
Yeah, it's a base lock, and I don't think they can survive long enough. It's a 1-0. Myanmar ahead.
Look at this. Myanmar going ham, finding the weakness of Philippines. You could see in their faces how satisfying is it to strike first blood.
You have to respect Naomi here, the amount of pressure that he put.